This is the urinary bladder. The ureters bring urine from both kidneys into the bladder where it's held and stored till it's about half a litre full. Then, when ready, the dome of the bladder contracts, the urethra opens, and it empties through this tube called the urethra. In males, the prostate sits underneath the bladder here and wraps around the urethra as well. I always need to go to the bathroom. I must have a small bladder. Now, we may have heard this saying before or even said it when we're out from our friends and family, but are you actually likely to have a physiologically smaller bladder? Well, the answer is probably not. It's unlikely that your bladder, or someone else's, has developed physiologically smaller or proportionally smaller compared to the growth of the other organs. So if it's not commonly the size of the bladder, what else could be going wrong and causing some people the need to void and go to the bathroom so much more regularly than others?
As it's unlikely that your bladder is small in that it's developed at a rate different to the rest of your organs, what else could be going on? And why then do some people have to go to the bathroom so much more often than others? Well, initially, you want to rule out diseases that can affect the urinary tract or urine production. Infections of the bladder, ureters or kidneys, diabetes, pregnancy, some cancers, bladder stones, or even prostate inflammation and enlargement in males, usually after they're about 50 years old. Also, bladder damage, scarring, trauma, or movement, particularly in women after childbirth, can impact on how much volume the bladder can physically hold. Alternatively, it could be related to lifestyle, drinking diuretics or excessive consumptions of fluid, alcohol, and coffee. See, if you're small and you try to maintain a 1-to-1 drink ratio with someone much larger than you, you'll actually be drinking more per body mass and have to urinate far more often. See, for example, a single can of beer actually results in a higher concentration of fluid and alcohol within the body of a smaller person compared to someone larger. So keep that in mind when you're out on the town, going 1-to-1 drinks with your friends, and wondering why the smaller people, even though they're drinking exactly the same number of drinks as everyone else, needs to go to the bathroom so much more regularly. One last issue to consider is it could be overactive bladder. This is a syndrome that results in a sudden urge to urinate, not necessarily incontinence, but just an occasionally painful but urgent need to rush to the bathroom. If you find yourself going to the bathroom more than around 8 times every 24 hours and up to or more than 2 times at night to urinate, it could be that you have an overactive bladder. There are medications and interventions that can help you. Your initial point of call will be a family doctor who can refer you to a urologist or a urogynecologist to get some further tests done and determine exactly what's going wrong down there.